Welcome students to one more session of your Hess Law. So in the previous video, what did I teach you? I've taught you what is the concept of Hess Law. So what did we learn? We said whether the reaction occurs in one step or whether it occurs in two or more steps, the total heat evolved is the same. Whether you calculate, maybe very minute difference. So that's why Hess Law is proven scientifically. Now today we are going to see the examples of Hess Law. Right? So let us take the most famous example, that is burning of carbon to carbonic. So that is nothing but combustion of carbon. Right. So we will take both the steps and see first. So we said burning of carbon, that means you need to burn carbon in the presence of oxygen. So this, let us see the first way and let us see the second way. I'm dividing the page into two equal halves. So this is your first way. This is your second way. Let's see. Now directly when carbon combines with oxygen, so first step should always be direct, second way should always be step by step. So first carbon, what is the state of carbon? It is nothing but solid. This combines with oxygen. What is the state of oxygen? It is gaseous. So both of them combine directly and form carbon dioxide gas. Now during this process, the amount of heat evolved, that is delta H, is -94.05 kilocalories per mole. This is per mole. So directly if they combine, they're going to combine this way, and so much amount of energy, exothermic reaction is going to evolve. Now suppose if it is going step by step, first what is the condition in step by step? First carbon is a solid, it's going to combine with molecule. This is also in gaseous state. What do they form first? They're going to form carbon dioxide gas. So in this first step, the energy released would be almost 26.42 kilocalories. Now in the second step, yes, so this carbon monoxide gas, so what do we write? Carbon plus oxygen gives me carbon dioxide. Now in the second step, the carbon monoxide gas combines with half oxygen forming carbon monoxide. So here the amount of heat evolved is -67.71 kilocalories. Now what did we do? Let us take the final thing. We need to cancel everything, isn't it? So carbon solid, this is overall change. then comes your after this carbon solid, then comes your oxygen, isn't it? Yes. How did I take? Now this is half oxygen molecule, this is half oxygen. Now subtract this, then you get, what do you get? Oxygen gas, isn't it? Yes. So here in this case, did we do something? Yeah. Now when I come to this case, this side, what do we get? We get carbon dioxide. Why? This one, carbon monoxide gets cancelled. Delta H value, if I take, delta H value is equal to -94.13 kilocalories. That's it. Minus and minus. So minus, plus of minus. So I got 94.13. Normally, if I do directly, I'm getting 94.05. But here, if I am doing, it in step by step, then too, I get 94.3. So this is the thing. Okay, maybe hope this isn't confusing you. Let us do one more. Let us see the formation of sodium hydroxide. Let us take the example 2. What is this? Formation of NaOH from sodium. Let us see this example. And here, first let us again divide the page into two halves. Let us take this as your first way. Let us take this as your second way. First way is always direct. So in first of all, if that happens, in sodium as a solid, it's going to combine with oxygen as a gas. What happens both when both combine? You get Na2O solid. Now here oxygen is half, so this is half. Here sodium is 2, so this is 2. During this process, see, every time you need to write the heat evolved, isn't it? It is -100 kilocalories. Now this Na2O, what does it do? This Na2O solid further combines with water, which is in liquid state, forming sodium hydroxide. Because we wrote formation of sodium hydroxide, isn't it? Sodium hydroxide. So when something is in this one, it's called aqueous solution, isn't it? So sodium is 2, so you've written 2. Now delta H value in this case is minus 56 kilocalories. Now write the overall reaction. This 2 sodium will come as 2 sodium salt plus. This Na2O and this Na2O gets cancelled, isn't it? So we will cancel this. So what is left? It is half O2 gas plus water is also there. Water gives me, this is 2, this got cancelled, so this is 2 NaOH, right? So now when you take these two, what is the value? Delta H value is minus 156, 100 plus 56, 156 kilocalories. Minus because the heat evolved, isn't it? That is due to second way. In the second way, sodium as a solid, it combines with water, liquid, to form what? Sodium plus water directly. I'm doing the second step. It forms sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gases evolved. So this is aqueous state. Now balance sodium. Here I have to take sodium 2. Okay, this is 2, and this is okay. This is 2, and this is also 2. Now, during this process, the energy released is minus 88 kilocalories. Now this hydrogen, whatever is evolved, it which is in gaseous state, it combines with oxygen again in gaseous state. Together they form water molecule, gaseous. Here delta H value is minus 156.5 kilocalories. Now let us cancel the whole thing. This hydrogen gets cancelled. Let's write sodium becomes 2 Na here. Water is here. Copy that water. L. Half oxygen is still there. That is gas. Together what do I get? I get, see here, this water and this water. I have to take, but here how much is hydrogen? 2, isn't it? I should balance this. I didn't balance this. I'm sorry. Now this one, 2 water molecules here, 1 water molecule. When you subtract, what do you get? You get only 1 water molecule. So this gets cancelled with 1. So I've written only 1. Okay, so this gets cancelled with this. Now what I'm left with? I'm left with NaOH, 2 NaOH, which is an aqueous. Now if I have to find the delta H value, it is minus 156 point, how much do we have? 88 in? Okay, 1 minute. What is this value? This is mistake I've written. So here the value is minus 68.5. I'm sorry, students. It is 68.5. This is 88 calories and this is 68.5. So again, you get an answer of 156.5 kilocalories. Now see here, if you are doing like this also, 156 kilocalories. If you are doing like this in step by step also, 156.5. So what you should remember, total heat evolved, whether it is in single step or a different way, the difference is 0.5 kilocalories. That experimental error always is there in this, right? So remember, thermochemical reactions, equations can be multiplied, they can be added or subtracted, like ordinary algebraic reactions, thermochemical reactions, always remember, you can do multiplication, you can do addition, you can, they can be added, they can be subtracted also. So for this reason only, Hess law is proven law. It's a great help for us. So you'll be studying this topic in thermochemistry basically. So remember, Hess law is experimentally proven. So thank you for watching, students. Let me meet you all again in the next topic, that is applications of Hess law. So in my next video. So hope you please practice the reactions. Thank you for watching.